I'm Sarah Flynn. I'm the founding president of the District 30 Democratic Club, and I served from 2005 till 2009. And I also served as Speaker Mike Bush's campaign manager in 2010. As I have said in the past, there were two impetuses for starting the District 30 Democratic Club. One was George Bush, and the other was Mike Bush. And the reason for that is that I got involved with the Carrie Edwards campaign in 2004. And I had kind of a hard time finding my way into that campaign. I eventually did. I met a lot of great people. And it became clear to a lot of us after the end of that campaign that it would be very disappointing not to keep all that energy together. We were also cognizant of living in Annapolis, which was, you know, quite Democratic, but the surrounding area of District 30, which then consisted of 47 precincts from Broad Neck all the way down to South County, really needed help, you know, mobilizing people. So the object was to bring people together to help elect Democrats. And to see the energy around all the Democratic campaigns in 2018 is just really heartwarming. We touched a lot of bases and talked to a lot of people to make sure before we even proposed this idea that people would like it. And they did. And in that vein, you know, I went to see the speaker and told him what we were thinking of doing. And he, of course, was quite excited and supported us. And, you know, we just learned so much about voter contact, about how, you know, the best form of voter contact is knocking on somebody's door and talking to them. And knocking on doors with Speaker Mike Bush was quite the experience. The speaker would be talking to somebody he had coached or had taught or, you know, and generations of people, you know, knew him. It was just really fun. And he was just, he treated everyone equally, you know. He just didn't care whether you were the low man on the totem pole or the high elected official. And that's, I think, part of his charm and why he was such a good politician, because he was so sincere. He really believed everything he said, and we just all got behind him. And one of the first things that attracted him, me to him, just in as an observer, was everything he did for healthcare in Maryland when CareFirst Blue Cross Blue Shield was trying to privatize things. And, so that was before I even knew him. But you know, he was into healthcare, the economy, jobs, the environment, and he had the whole package. And he was just such a real person. And, you know, I mean, he'd walk into a room and say, "Who's better than us?" he just was such a delight to help, you know. And I hope that, people take to heart the way he treated people, the way he cared so much about people, you know, whether people of Annapolis or District 30 or the county or the state or and the country. He really wanted to do things for people. He didn't want to be something. He wanted to do something.